touch from Perisic into Modric, who's quite clearly manhandled to the floor by the Brazilian right back, Eder Militao. Sending it forward was Thiago Silva stooping to clear space for Neymar. First chance really we've had to see him stretching his legs and going deep into Croatian territory. Referee allows the game to continue, but it breaks down via the boot of Rafinha. Kramaric can't keep it in.
Run from Neymar was upended a little bit towards right at the end of that run. Rafinha here in possession has got to again do a little bit more with the ball at his feet.
Marquinhos sent it away to Danilo, now Vinicius Junior. Another test coming up for Juranovic, but again the ball in, not off the required quality.
It's a waste. And it's key to what Brazil do, the way that those wide men play. It really is. If they're not having an effect on the game, then you start going a little bit more direct, just trying to play through the middle a little too much. And that's where Croatia are really strong.
Danilo sending it through. Neymar can't find Vinicius Junior. Again, it's Josip Juranovic who comes away with the ball. Modric sending it back to him. Juranovic doing really well. Croatia asking a few questions of Brazil here with Ivan Perisic, who sent it in just over the top of the head of the forward rushing Mario Pašalić.
Lucky. Yeah. I'm not surprised to see a change in those areas. It's about to happen. Anthony looks like he's about to enter the frame. Clever ball this from Perisic. Just a bit heavy for Pašalić, but a good run. Man on the far side into the box, but
yeah, Rafinha's time on the pitch may be coming to an end shortly in this quarter final with Anthony ready to go. Brazil looking for a little bit more.
One thing that Chite does have is tremendous options to choose from. He's got Anthony coming on, he's got Martinelli. Here's Rodrigo, Bruno, there's some fabulous forward-thinking players here.
Here's Rafinha. Neymar. Back with Danilo, his versatility is a real plus for Brazil. It's come in handy here as well with the injury to Alexandro. That's a nice turn there from Richarlison. Could be a chance blocked by Ivanovic again to deny Neymar.
What a stop.
Vinicius Junior.
It's the first time Richarlison had actually rolled Fadio there.
Ivanovic has gone down. I think it might be a blow to the head, yes, and that's why the referee has stopped the game.
What a chance that was, though. Really was a good chance. I'm sure Juranovic will be okay. Watch Richarlison here. When he picks the ball, he just rolls to Vardio, drags him out of position. Now all of a sudden there's gaps. And there's Neymar there on that left foot. Doesn't really hit the strike with any snap or any fizz in it. And it's a pretty routine stop that. That's a really good chance. He's got to do better than that.
Anthony onto the field to replace Rafinha. Anthony, you had the start against Cameroon, the match they lost, and came off the bench in the other two group games. This is his first appearance in the knockout stages. Rafinha takes a seat. First change of the match. It's made by Chite, the coach of Brazil. And here's a first touch for Anthony, who finds Richarlison, who gets there first, and it's just out of reach for Lucas Paqueta.
It's a good ball there from Anthony. It's a really good ball. Richarlison, he wasn't making part of it, played it well. It's a really good ball. Again, somebody's got someone who's really stretching to reach the ball as he is here. Someone's got to get it towards that near post. Someone has to really try and get there. I think it was Paqueta, very nearly got it.
Coach Chite was actually very complimentary of Anthony. He's described him as having velvet feet and says he has some similar technical characteristics to Neymar. Modric, back to Dejan Lovren, and now Josko Gvardiol. It's based in Germany with RB Leipzig for now.
Here they go again, Croatia take the heat out of the situation. Just had to withstand a little bit of pressure there, haven't they? So now, let's keep it again for 5 minutes.
Just trying to take the sting out of the game. Stop Brazil from building up too much momentum. Still nothing in it in terms of possession. Bit more of the ball in contest than during the first half. Kovacic. Measured, diligent approach from Croatia continues. Juranovic sets it back. Lovren.
It's when to put it in the box for them, isn't it? They're just waiting for that right moment, don't they? Just feel that they don't have quite enough. So they're coming back out with the ball, they'll reset, recycle it right back to the halfway line.
That's Brozovic sending it forward, Andrei Kramaric, back to Marcelo Brozovic, claiming a handball, but it was from point blank range, and away comes Richarlison now for Brazil. Sending it through towards Vinicius Junior. Lovren was there for Croatia.
Great challenge.
Time for Thiago Silva.
Chance there, wasn't there, for Brazil. Game became a little bit more stretched, which will happen. Second half, of course, players are going to get tired. Can't become the opposition quite as quickly.
Something more broken for a moment there. Anthony has it once more. Manchester United player. Towards Richarlison, trying to get away from Gvardiol once more.
What a goalkeeper. Had to be alive and alert, didn't he? This was just before he left the field and played that. Could easily have gone in from Gvardiol. Else sticks a leg out to try and block that across the 6 yard line. Goalkeeper have to be nice and quiet. Alert to him, deals with it.
Did well there, and Livakovic saved a couple of attempts on goal with his right foot in the second half. Here comes Juranovic, who continues his run. Back with Luka Modric. It's aimed in the direction of Kramaric, who has scored a couple of goals in this World Cup. He got 2-4-1 win over Canada in the group stage. Croatia still without an effort on target in this match. 4 shots on goal, but it really stretching Alisson too much thus far. Neymar. Away from Brozovic. Not by Lovren before it could reach Vinicius Junior.
He's defending well tonight as well, Dejan Lovren. Really good. That was a clever bit of play there from Neymar. Very unlucky to try and find Vinicius.
Kovacic. Croatia keeping the ball well. Gvardiol. It's got Sosa on the near side. Here's Mateo Kovacic. Just at the moment, it's Brazil chasing.
Yeah. The press from Brazil now, not quite as intense. situation very confidently, stroking it about from side to side.
Amrich finds Modric and takes up a position right on the edge of the penalty area. A free kick as Modric goes over. Neymar tries to bring Paqueta into the play. Modric is snapping away at his ankles. Juranovic sending it into Modric. No joy for Perisic. And breaks loose. That time off Casemiro. Kovacic just dropping back, making himself available. Looking for an opening. Perisic, it's easy for hours.
Yeah, lucky. Dominant just in front. Four in front of him there, Perisic, to really give Kramaric something to go at, but...
Brazil shortly. Rodrigo preparing to come on. He's appeared in all of the matches at this World Cup. More often than not, off the bench.
I can understand, Chito, why he wants to get his attack-minded players in the game. Of course they want to score, but the longer the game goes on, Croatia are brilliant at running the clock down, draining you, taking the game into that extra time. But that's an area that they know very well. They know how to deal with that, manage that. I think Chito is trying to take the upper hand by getting those forward players out there, getting those fresh legs in those dangerous areas as much as he can.
Anthony, back into Lucas Paqueta. Edo Militao, well forward. Was waiting. Change coming for Brazil here, and Rodrigo continues his